the rise in popularity of digital SLRs, it's become easy for anyone to try their hand at amateur wildlife photography. We were lucky enough to catch up with Rob English to find out what some of his favorite hotspots are for catching that wildlife in action in and around Calgary. Well, you don't have to travel miles and miles out into the country to find some of the perfect opportunities to catch wildlife. Now, Mr. Rob English knows all about that. He's a wildlife photographer, and you know, you can literally find tons of great stuff in and around Calgary. But Rob, what's one of your favorites?
Sicomi Lake in Fish Creek Park. It's easy, accessible, straight down Bow Bottom Trail. And there's been a variety of wildlife there over the years. There's great horned owls usually there. They nest there every year. I've got mink along by the creek itself, and also a weasel there one year. It was in there, and it was spectacular.
What's it like? Is there a lot of people down there? A lot of foot traffic?
A lot of foot traffic, and this is part of the problem with wildlife in the city now, that there is so much, since the population of the city has increased so much, there's an awful lot of people pressure on parks and whatnot, and some of the animals and birds can adapt to it, others can't, and they just move on.
Well, whether you have a digital SLR and all the lenses, or it's simply your camera phone that you enjoy taking pictures on, once you've got the camera, it's time to find a great spot to get out there and find some of that wildlife. Rob, what is one of your favorite spots here in Calgary?
Another one of my favorite spots is Burns Mead Ponds. It's straight down Bow Bottom Trail, right at the entrance to Fish Creek Park, as a matter of fact, the first left coming to the park. And there's a memorial tree forest there, which it actually harbors a lot of wildlife too. You can get jackrabbits in there. I've had pileated woodpeckers in there. And if you go down the road a little further, there's two stormwater ponds, which there's been great blue herons there. They've had pelicans land in there, cormorants, and a wide variety of ducks, plus a few other red, yellow-headed blackbirds, red-winged blackbirds, and that sort of stuff. It is quite a place, but you have to have a little bit of patience, and lots of times the birds will stay for you, other times they're gone, and if you wait long enough, they'll come back.
So patience is the game when you're a wildlife photographer.
Patience is the game, yes.
We are so fortunate to have so many beautiful wildlife areas in and around Calgary. Fish Creek is one of the largest urban parks in North America. What's one of your favorite spots, Rob?
Well, Bebo Grove comes to mind. 2 years ago there, there was a pair of pygmy owls, and they caused a real storm with the photographers and people in general. They just took over the whole area, because it's not that often that you see them, and they were in the area, and people just took it by storm. In fact, it got out of hand. That the parks people, they had to do something about it and whatnot, and restricted people in some areas just because of the numbers. And you can get a variety of woodpeckers in there, three-toed woodpeckers, downy woodpeckers, You get a lot of small birds, irregular chickadees, boreal chickadees, and it's just a great place to walk through. It really is. And a lot of the small birds, chickadees, which you're not supposed to feed, but people do or anything, but they will come right to your hand and feed right out of your hand, which is great for kids.
So I guess you get an opportunity to get some really close-up photos and stuff.
Oh, yeah.
Too, you get to be a little bit more creative, probably.
Yeah, they sit for you really nice.
They're posing.
Yes.
Well, many people would probably be surprised to find out how many amazing inner city places they can go to see some wildlife, Rob.
Oh yeah, it's Carbon Park comes to mind. It's one of my favorites, probably because when I was a kid, I played in that area before River Bend or Carbon Park was even a park. So it's got a little history with me being in the area all this time. And before the 2013 flood, most people that went into that park just thought it was the hidden jewel of the city because it had all kinds of wildlife, all kinds of birds, animals, and everything. And it was just a great, just great. But since the flood, and like all river parks, it took the brunt of it and it had a whole lot of damage. And it's taking a time for it to come back. I noticed the last 2 years, the wildlife is starting to come back. The animals and the birds, and there's deer in there, there's I've got porcupines in there, there's beaver in the pond, which some people have pros and cons on that because of the damage they do to the trees and whatnot, but it's just an all-round place, easy to get to. It's just off River Bend, and the problem is that it's people pressure, and there's a lot of people with dogs in there. So if you know, it's a great place to go, but people have to look after the area.
Absolutely.
You know, honor it.
What is your most prized photograph from Carbon Park?
Prized from Carbon, I would say when the owls nested there at the parking lot. They created quite a stir, and it was another thing. There was people all from all over the city came because they were right, just had to drive into the parking lot. The nest was right up in the tree there and whatnot. But the photos that I enjoyed the most out of there was after a rainfall, because these poor owls were just sopping wet and their feathers are all matted and they just look so miserable that it was really great. I really enjoyed that. That's one of my favorite photos.
What about some of the bigger predators that you've seen at Carbon Park?
Well, there's eagles and there's ospreys. And there's a pair of eagles that nest there just right by across from the heritage car lots there. They've nested there for years and whatnot. Last year, they had two young. As a matter of fact, one came over when it fledged and it was on the ground in the park. I got some photos of it on the ground, and actually, the parks people thought it was hurt, but it wasn't. It was just a case that it got tired and it come down onto the ground and it just sat there while I took photos. And then the ospreys, well, there's ospreys up and down the river, but there was also a pair that nested over beside the golf course that's there, the driving range and whatnot. My biggest goal is to get an osprey diving for a fish and picking it out of the water. I've never been able to get one yet, and that's something that I'm still going after.
The elusive photo.
The elusive photo.
Now, there are a few spots within the city limits that some people might not immediately recognize as a great spot for wildlife photography. What is one of your spots for wildlife photography that you think many people don't think of as a hot spot?
Well, I have to say Nose Hill Park. Nose Hill Park seems to be more noted for the walking crew and the jogging and the cyclists. There's there has been conflicts up there amongst these people, but it was the first place that I was I ever got long-eared owls, and I heard about them up there, and I found them and got the photos and whatnot. But there are deer. I found deer up there. I found porcupine up there. There's coyotes. Actually, coyotes have had conflicts with dog walkers up there. And but it's a place where I don't think that everybody would go to, you know.
Well, if you're new to wildlife photography or you've been doing it for years, there are two things to keep in mind. The most important elements, patience and location. Now, Rob, what is one of your favorite spots to spend some time waiting for that perfect photo?
Down in the Weasel Head. It's on the west end of the reservoir, right down to the bottom of the hill. There's qualipi hummingbirds in there and roofing hummingbirds in there. And it takes time. Sometimes they're very flighty, but if they've established a territory, they will come back. So if you sit there long enough, they'll come back and you'll be able to get a few shots in there. I've got deer in there. I had a thrill of a lifetime. I almost stepped on this fawn. The mother, she didn't come around, but I was doing the hummingbirds and walking through the bush, and I just backed up a little bit and put my foot down, and I looked, and here was a fawn, just a little fella, all curled up there. It was so cute and whatnot, so I kind of took a few pictures, and then I covered it over better than Mom had it hidden, and then I left the area and whatnot, but didn't even get my hummingbird shots because I didn't want to stay there. But you can get pine grosbeaks in there, crossbills. There's been a saw-whet owl spotted in there lately, which is a novelty owl too. You just don't see it all the time, and it creates a great stir amongst the photographers in the city. Everybody wants to get one of those.
Awesome. Weasel Head. Well, riverways and woodlands are obvious spots to catch some great wildlife photography, but there's also some not so obvious spots to catch some great photography. Rob, what's one of your favorites?
Well, Ralph Klein Park, it's a park that was dedicated to our illustrious past mayor that has passed away. And out there, it's a great spot for migratory birds. In the fall and spring, you'll have swans come in there, trumpeter swans and whistling swans. And they'll come into that area. You'll find shorebirds, lots of ducks, American avocets, a shorebird, black-backed stilts, you'll find there. And it's a great place, but it's wide open. Sometimes it's hard to get photography going there because it's so open. The birds sometimes just don't take to you too well. And close by to Ralph Klein Park, there's the old town of Shepherd. Lots of ducks come in there to feed and whatnot. Pheasant would come around there. You go a little further down the road and the road splits a slough. And like I say, you get swans in there, American avocets, black-backed stilts. There's muskrat in the pond there. And just American coots, a whole variety of shorebirds right in. And it's right in close to town too. It's just on on the east side of Stony Trail.
Parks, rivers, lakes, waterways, you name it, they're all great places to find wildlife. But Rob, what if people are up for taking a little drive, heading out into the prairies? What are some great places they could find too?
Well, the place that I like the best is north of Strathmore to Bicycler. It's bounded by Highway 9 over to Highway 21. And this is a snowy owl location. And I mean, this is a place you only go. The snowy owls might show up towards the last week of October, first week of November, and generally they're gone by the middle of March. But it's a great place for snowy owls, and they are just fantastic birds. Some of those males that are just pure white with the big gold eyes, so pretty. Everybody's goal is to get them either on a fence post or on the ground, because usually they sit on the power poles and you're stuck with wires in your photos, unless you got Photoshop, you know. And also in that area you can get rough-legged hawks, which are birds that are basically winter around this area. In the spring they'll migrate back north again and whatnot. And there's lots of those in that particular area. And the odd time you might get lucky. I did catch a badger one time out there, that neck of the woods. He was digging for gophers or whatever at the time. Dirt was flying, and that was great. But that's a place to go if you want to go for a little drive.
How long of a drive would you say outside of Calgary?
Probably to get into the area, it'd probably be anywhere 30 to 45 minutes.
Okay.
And then, of course, you patrol the roads, back roads, and back and forth, cover the area.
Wetlands provide some unique opportunities for spotting wildlife. Rob, what's one of your favorite wetland spots to catch some great photos?
Well, the Bridlewood wetlands comes to, Bridlewood ponds actually comes to mind. They're on James McKivitt and Highway 22X. And they're just stormwater ponds, excess water that runs off the street and whatnot. But you can, there's Canada geese in there, and they have young there all the time. There's the redneck grebes, bi-billed grebes, red-headed ducks, and ruddy ducks, which I think are actually comedians there. They have a real bright blue bill, and they're a rust color. They're pretty little guys and whatnot, but some of the antics they do when they're going through their mating rituals and whatnot, it's really comical. And that's a great place to get those. So there's, and of course, there's yellow-headed blackbirds. There is actually some red-winged blackbirds, and there was black terns there, and they can be very vicious. They nest in kind of a colony. The year that they were there, there could have been probably 20 birds in there, and I was on the bank, and they're very defensive, and they got together and they chased me off the bank. They kept diving at me and whatnot. They chased me off the bank back to my car. So you gotta be careful too.
Taking your life in your hands out there. we're lucky enough to have some beautiful scenery and some great views, especially if you're willing to drive just a little bit outside the city limits. And with those great views come some great opportunities to see some spectacular wildlife. Rob, what's one of your favorites?
Out near Prittis, that's west on Highway 22X, and I've got great gray owls out there. They're spectacular birds. Everybody wants great gray owls and whatnot. And in the area also are bluebirds. There's nest boxes up all along the roads about there. People have put them up and maintain them, and there's a few banding people around that they band the birds and whatnot when the young ones come out. And they're banded, and they keep track of them. Keep track of the numbers in the area because populations fluctuate and they go up and down and whatnot. And last year was the first year I got a bobolink. I'd never seen a bobolink before. I didn't know what a bobolink was, but I did see one, and it was an experience.
What is a bobolink? I have to ask.
It's like a blackbird, but it's got kind of a yellowy gold crown on it. And it's a very nice bird.
Any other bigger game that you've seen out there?
I've seen a big herd of elk hang around in that area. Also moose. I've got moose in that area. And I've got grosbeaks and evening grosbeaks and rosy grosbeaks. And it is quite an area, and it's not far.
Out west towards Prittis, it's a pretty big area. Is there somewhere specific that we can spot some of this wildlife?
Well, if you go into town and then head south to and come across a road called Plumber's Road and follow that road around, and that's where I've been successful for great greys and moose. You have to cruise the area.
Yeah.
A lot of these places, it's the same thing. I mean, outside of in the park here, mm-hmm. in Fish Creek and the local parks, once you get out of town, you're doing back roads and just cruising the roads and seeing what you might come across.
So whether you're an amateur photographer, a professional, or you simply enjoy the outdoors, any season is a perfect time to get out and explore Calgary and its beautiful surroundings. Thanks so much for joining us, and a special thanks to Rob English. I'm Erin Strait. We'll see you again.